Hey guys, welcome back to StarCityGames.com Commander Versus, brought to you by StarCityGames.com Star City Game Night. Jeremy, we're back with another special episode.
I know. It seems like we just started this series and we're already at 11 episodes.
Seasons.
What?
It's 11 seasons.
That's what I said. Anyway, I just wanted to thank StarCityGames.com for putting up with us for so long. And of course, we need to thank you, our wonderful fans.
Absolutely. And I think I am just about...
You having some trouble shuffling there?
Well, I don't have any sleeves for my tokens.
You know where you can get some sleeves?
No, we're going to get sleeves.
You can get sleeves at StarCityGames.com. In fact, you can get StarCityGames.com Creature Collection sleeves at StarCityGames.com.
Where could I get these StarCityGames.com tokens?
In fact, you can get these StarCityGames.com tokens at StarCityGames.com's Star City Game Night.
Well, Jeremy, I think I'm ready.
I'm ready.
And if you guys are ready, we'll see you in the Star City Game. It's one of our favorite times of the year, Johnny Appleseed Day. And we're here to celebrate in the best way we know how
with a game of Commander. For this episode, since we're celebrating such an important historical figure, we decided to play to our historical strengths. So for this episode, I'm going to be playing a Simic big mana deck helmed by Prime Speaker Zegana.
Where the hell is Steven?
I'd go pretty deep with my choice. There's a lot of options. There's Lindol the Necromancer, Erebos, Bantu.
Today I'm playing Xur, because I like to win. As you can tell by my beautiful Season 10 trophy.
Gonti, Drana, Kalidus, the other Kalidus, Razaketh, Gulkalar Gissa, Endrixar.
I'm gonna be honest, I forgot we were doing this today. I had someone to make me a deck, I don't even know what it is.
But in the end, I had to go with my BFF. Yeah.
I'm excited to see what everyone else brought to the table for one of the most loved holidays here on Commander Versus.
Are we done here?
There's just a couple Good. More shots awesome. I want to get for safety. John.
Hey guys, welcome back to Commander Versus series. That season. This is, we don't have a season.
It's rabbit season.
It's wabbit season.
It's duck season.
You have to say it like that. So we are, we're gathered here today for our favorite holiday on Commander Versus.
Christmas?
No.
Halloween is my favorite.
No.
4th of July.
No.
Close.
Dr. Kyle, do you have a guess?
Oh, Mother's Day.
Holidays. Great. Johnny Appleseed Day, of course.
Right.
Yeah. Every year we like to celebrate Johnny Appleseed Day. So of course today we have just decided to play with things that we like.
Yeah, just whatever we wanted.
Just whatever we wanted, we just play with it.
Sure.
Do we, Justin?
Yep. All of us are just gonna play with whatever
I'm
we want.
I'm very excited.
What are you playing with today?
Obviously, I'm playing with Yahenni.
Of course.
Oh, okay.
Why wouldn't?
Because we can play with whatever we want.
Yeah.
What's your favorite card to play with in that?
It is the Dictate of Erebos.
Oh, okay.
Obviously, see, people think that it's Grave Pact, but Dictate has Flash.
Yeah, it's Grave Pact with
so
Flash.
You can just Flash people all the time.
Yeah.
Just they never
matter
see
what
it.
Turn it
they
is.
Never see it coming, just right into play.
Mm-hmm.
It fits with your
We like to call it the Parnell.
Yeah.
Parnelling.
We do call it Parnelling.
So here we are.
I mean, you're really lucky that hasn't been banned, you know, being able to Flash that.
But you can't, but it's, here it is.
Yeah.
Mm. You're just like, boo.
Yeah, there it is.
Just right on the table. No one never prepared.
What you
just
gotta, your deck?
And you just gotta sacrifice all the creatures.
Yeah. Sacrifice.
Oh, Grave Pack is in there, too.
Okay. Yeah, of course. Of course. But I mean, I felt like I've talked about this
terrible
deck
Rivals card.
Plenty.
Yeah.
It's Bonus Hunger.
What is that card? That's the new one, right? Rivals?
Yeah, from Rivals Vixlan. Yeah.
I don't like that.
Send, like,
Sacrifice.
Everyone sacrifices half of their creatures.
Half their creatures.
That's right.
Creatures?
Round it up.
Wow. That's fine.
You play a deck like that, you're never getting the city's blessing.
All opponents. Yeah, I always have the city's blessing.
Never.
I've always been blessed by the city.
What are you doing, John?
Yeah, John.
I'm playing Xur. Everybody knows I love Xur. So when I play with Yahenni, I wanted to play with...
So like some kind of prison deck.
No, nonsense.
What's that Angel of Jubilation doing?
Well, I knew you were going to play some sort of shenanigans. So. Yeah. It says players can't pay life or sacrifice creatures to cast spells or activate abilities, and I'm sure you want to do something along that line. Like, give your creature +1/+1.
That's literally all I want to do.
Yeah, so I put that in there for you. I have Ashes of the Abhorrent. That's a pretty sweet card. I don't know. Players can't cast spells from graveyards or activate abilities in graveyards. That's more the same. And then I have Solemn Enmity because Jeremy loves putting creatures on things. Counters on things.
I love putting creatures on counters.
That's true. I do like.
Well, you also have two enchantments.
Well, yeah. So Steven can't interact with my deck at all because it's just all enchantments.
That's true.
That's normally how that works.
It's going to be true of this deck.
Jeremy, do you put in counters on your things?
I'm going to try some counters on my things.
Players can't get counters. Counters can't be put on artifacts, creatures, enchantments, or lands.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna play with Prime Speaker Zegana this week.
So you'll draw one.
I'll draw one.
Excellent.
If you have Solemnity out.
Hey, Will.
Why do you have this one in your deck? That doesn't seem very good.
Mythic Rare. Yeah, he's playing Team Orange.
We're playing Team Orange today. So we're going to be playing blue-green nonsense like I like to do, and putting counters on things, hopefully getting counters on things like Master Biomancer, and then we can,
nonsense.
No, and then... There's like a bit of a merfolk sub theme in it, so we're gonna do that. And make them bigger, swingy. Oof. That's what we're doing.
Mm. Yeah, that doesn't use counters.
No, it does not.
Unfortunately,
that just makes your team grow very big.
Yeah, if we can do this into that,
no,
I don't know, I'll be able to.
Yeah, that would get the prime speaker.
So you're playing
excited.
Creatures.
Yeah.
Oh, that's unfortunate. So I'm playing Ashling. Ashling the Pilgrim.
Well, if you had to pick a best friend card, for Ashling.
Mountain. Yeah.
Are you
sure? That's
how
my deck tech is all mountains. Now, there are some goodies in here, but what you need to know is this is what it's going to be. It's going to be this into this, right? And then we're going to cast this.
Got it.
Yeah. Right? And then the next turn, hopefully, we're going to put another mountain into play, and then we're going to really start,
Yeah.
After that,
on the next turn, we'll do it two more times.
Okay.
All right.
Now, hold on.
That's three, right?
That's three.
Yeah.
And then what happens when it has three?
It kills all Jeremy's creatures.
Ooh.
It actually does damage equal to the number of remove all 1/1 counters, deal that much damage to each creature and each player. Yeah, it'll kill Ashling, but it will do its work.
This is also coming for you.
Well, it's not meant for it, but it's nice to have.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little side.
Yeah, you're gonna stop it?
A little side action.
No, I could just blow up for one a bunch.
Yeah. Bang.
Or zero, I guess.
Zero
counters.
Yeah.
But excellent. I can blow it up.
You can. It's your prerogative.
And that's right. Exactly how much lands I need.
Yeah, count them again. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lands.
Ooh.
Where'd you get the other one?
Yeah. No mulligans?
I like to cheat.
Okay. All right. Well, if you guys are ready to take it.
I'm ready.
To the next level. And you guys are ready for Johnny Appleseed Day. We'll see you in the game. Nah, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. It's Johnny Appleseed Day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought
I was going to griff someone.
You still can griff someone.
Hold on. Let's do it, John.
No.
You ready for this?
No.
Yeah. Grift him. Grift him, Steven. Steven, grift him.
What is going on?
First of all, that is not how that card works.
Yeah, you didn't even read the card.
You didn't read the card.
Yeah, get these out of here.
It does. It says I put this
you
in mountains failed. And
you
we
have to,
do the
You have to show them I which did. One. You know, you, then you shuffle it in your hand.
Yeah.
You really tried to grift him.
Yeah, I still don't understand what's going on.
Well, you pick one now. This is the game. You stop it.
You have to choose. If you choose a mountain, he gets to blow up a permanent. If you choose the grifter, then it gets sacrificed.
You got double grifted.
Grifted twice.
This is silly.
Right? You got double grifted. Why would you do that? So, Steven, what are you playing? You're playing the...
I'm grifted.
You're playing the Jom Grifter. So, I don't want to reveal the secrets of any of these decks, but obviously we're going to be playing with... With cards we don't normally get to play with.
Yeah.
So Steven's grifting people.
Yeah. You have a lot of coins. I'm flipping some coins.
Grifty like
cards. And a griffin. And we're playing a goblin game.
And hiding some stuff.
All yeah. Right.
All right.
Behind my back, exactly like this.
Yeah. There's a lot of objects in this room.
Yeah.
Well, a ton of objects in this room.
Yeah.
Can't wait, especially the doge pillow.
No, we won't use
we're
that.
We're going to hide them in the doge pillow and then hide them.
Oh, that would be sneaky. Yeah, that'd be very sneaky.
John, you only have
like,
five cards.
Like Phoebe, the agent of sneak.
She's very sneaky.
Oh, that's
she's
right. She's so sneaky, she's not here because Steven decided to throw my commander on the ground. So, yeah, anyways, that's what I'll be playing.
She can steal things.
Yeah,
that's what I hear.
She can steal some text.
Yeah, why don't you read what she does?
No, it's okay, Steve. I can't because you threw it over there.
You know what? Fortunately, the viewers can because we have it on the little
overhead. Right. It's right here.
Thank goodness for them.
Ding. What's really important is that I'm getting to play Commander All-Star Head Games.
This is a magic rule now, right?
What?
If you like draw extra cards and then they can prove it, they just head games you. Your opponent gets to head games you.
Yeah,
that's the exact text. Kind of. I think.
I don't think that's the exact rule, but that's close.
I think that it's exactly.
It's very close.
If your opponent draws extra cards, resolve
head games.
You actually resolve Vendilion Click's ability for the number of times that they've drew an extra card.
Yeah, head games.
That's actually
no.
What the
put that
say.
Back. Put that one back. You don't get that.
He's gonna throw away all of your cards.
That's okay. I've got some good ones. He can keep throwing them over there. They're gonna keep coming.
So I'm playing Frankie Peanuts.
This is something you've been talking about for a while.
I don't want to play Frankie Peanuts forever. It's just I've never had the opportunity to play Frankie Peanuts. So beginning of my upkeep. I can ask Steven a yes or no question, and he has to answer honestly and then abide by what he said.
Give me an example.
Until end of turn. Steven, if I try to kill Jeremy, are you going to try to stop me?
No, there's no points involved.
That's about as honest as a yes.
Steven, if I attack you, are you going to block?
Yes.
Okay, now you have to block.
If able.
If able. You have to do it.
All right. I like
Keep
it.
In mind... I might not be attacking with Frankie Peanuts. Might be attacking with something
turn
else.
Every turn is like the whole game.
At the beginning of your upkeep, ask target player yes or no question. Then you have to answer honestly, and then you have to abide.
Until like my next
like
turn,
do.
Or like the whole game?
Until in a turn.
Okay.
During my turn.
Okay.
Yeah. Now.
A little preaching
going
on.
Now, unless I have staying power in play, then if I ask you a question, you have to honestly abide by the answer to that question forever.
I don't think so.
Effects don't end. Don't end ever, game or no game, for life.
Steven, are you gonna block when someone attacks you next?
Never.
So you can never block again.
Never ever.
Then you can never block again.
Got it.
So that's what this deck is doing.
All right.
We've been talking about the fact that I cannot seem to make meld happen forever, so I decided to force the issue, and I'm going with Griselda Monster Masher, which not exactly meld, but it's close enough.
You're mashing it.
It's mashing.
You're mashing it.
So we're going to do things like, you know, give some stuff indestructible and mash it together with some others. Does somebody
really got to read this?
You're snails?
Right now, no.
Okay.
Soon.
We're going to have a couple of the host augment stuff, because it also makes those have menace as well.
It gives them that's the whole name.
So, I know, right?
So if you can prime.
We're going to make sure that everybody's got enough stuff in the graveyard for me to take by forcing everyone to discard or destroying all your stuff, and I can grab stuff.
I see what's
out of
going
deck.
On. I don't like
and
it.
And then I also have some like fun utility stuff.
Yeah, fun.
That looks,
that's what
that looks
say
like
when
a
they
bunch
have
of necrotic. Bunch of BS.
Fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fun.
I'm gonna combine all of these together.
I don't even normally play that card.
Hey, mm-hmm. Listen.
An attack.
You're half right. It was definitely S.
Yep.
Here's an indestructible Necroticus coming at me.
No, no, its name is Dark Steel Mirror Necroticus.
That's
what it says.
Dark Steel Mirror Croticus.
Dark Steel Mirror Croticus, yeah.
It says it right there on the card, Steven.
Well, I'm ready to open
Sire
some packs.
Of Insanity.
I bet you are. You have the nice little the promo booster.
Yeah,
you do?
Yeah. Yep.
Got a mirrored and packed my name on it.
If you guys are ready to celebrate Johnny Appleseed Day, if you guys are ready, we'll see you in the game. We're not going to do that. We're not going to do that either.
Nah.
So what we actually are going to do is we've taken a look at EDH Rec, which is a website that we all know and love and use frequently. Mm-hmm. So we've decided to play some of the least loved commanders on EDH Rec. So
pretty sure all of these have zero decks.
Zero decks. Count one. There'll be a deck now. I am going to be playing Gallowbraid.
All right.
John is going to be playing Lu Su, Wu Advisor.
Woo!
Steven's going to be playing Tarek's Bladewing. It's your noise for everything.
You don't have to take that.
Yeah. Jeremy's going to be playing Zuchi, the Mocking Sage.
Mock you this entire game.
You have been. I mean, I feel like we...
You are a mockery already.
Yeah,
I feel like we've, you know... We won't apologize for last one. It's like we, you know, we're just trying to have fun today. Yeah. So, I don't want to call it a mistake.
Never.
We don't make mistakes.
That's true. You know what? I won't call it a mistake because we don't make mistakes.
Yeah, we don't.
On Commander Versus, that's well known. So, you know what? We've wasted enough of your time. So if you guys are ready and you guys are ready, we'll see you in the game. Hey guys, welcome again.
I like it. They're talking about their life in turns now. That's all they have.
Because it doesn't do anything after this turn, basically.
Well, they need to kill an Akromo or they're dead.
Yeah, because he will kill us with general all damage. We're going to mirror weave the germ token.
Each other creature becomes a copy of target non-legendary creature until end of turn.
I'm gonna respond.
Okay.
I'm gonna give this creature +2/+2.
Okay.
Does that not work?
Well, it's fine. That works. It does work.
Yeah. Another hook. So that dies.
So this resolves?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. So they're all dead.
Why are they all dead?
No. It makes everything a 0/0.
Well, this is definitely not gonna die.
No, that isn't, but a chroma is.
No, because he's a 2/2.
+2/+2.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I was asking, and you said it's fine. You can do that.
Do they become colorless or what? Oh, they become black still. All right.
It's fine.
Okay.
I thought that did actually work.
No. Oh, makes it a 0/0. I know you know what I meant.
Yeah. I'm going to play.
Oh boy.
Tapped, Colostri Highborn.
It's a sweet Colostri.
That is a sweet Colostri Highborn.
That is sweet.
Would you like to discard and give it haste?
No, I don't think I do.
Okay.
What if I can untap it?
Did you play a land this turn?
No, I wish.
So it wasn't a land.
It was not a land.
Was it Colostri Highborn?
It was not Colostri Highborn.
I guess we'll never know. Until we watch the video.
Steven, I'm going to attack you just with Drana. That's it. I just want to get my pump on.
I don't lose anything.
No, you don't.
Okay.
But, well, you do.
I gain it right back.
That's true.
Well, I got to draw this card.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to keep...
What are we doing?
Those are mine.
Just hold on a second, because I'm going to keep looking.
Ooh, I like it.
Looking.
You heard him? Uh-oh.
What you looking for?
Wing shards. Oh, no.
Harrow.
You only sack
one land.
One land. One,
yeah. And you go get two.
You're gonna gain two life.
Lord, I have two basics left.
28. They're untapped.
They are untapped.
Well, there's only one of them.
Oh no.
You're at 27.
I'm at critical mass.
Draw a card.
You already did.
I did.
Drew a Terrivore and a Reaping Sow.
Terrible.
Yeah.
Four?
Yeah.
Okay. That's all.
Yeah, now I have four.
Don't let him make, like, that's all.
Hey, it's okay.
That's all.
I just want a little tiny bite.
I wanted to make up for all the non-legends we were running as generals this time.
Yeah, I got some legends.
I got some legends. I also got, you know, some stuff to put bigger creatures in my graveyard or in the play.
Yeah.
At instant speed because this card is crazy.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Commander Versus Series Special Edition. Justin Parnell, Stephen Green.
I reckon so.
Jeremy Knoll, and Stephen Green.
No, that's my sister, Stephanie. don't have to be war, but I had to establish.
It doesn't have to be war, but I did just attack you for 6 and asked you if you wanted to go.
I just told him, you know, ahead of time that
I'm tapping.
Six mana.
I'm going to cast Progenitor Mimic. Propagator Mage.
Propagator Mage, Charlotte Holland stuff.
And I'm also going to make a copy of it.
Oh boy, this is going to get out of hand.
Going to get out real quick.
Wish someone had a black sun cleaner.
Well, maybe another one pop up.
They have a way of doing
black sun cleaner.
What are you propagating?
Can't do that.
I don't think it targets out Lightning Greaves.
Most clone effects don't target.
Yeah.
Battlefield as a copy of
any creature. Most clones don't. So
we'll go with this one for here.
Okay.
And then this one will be. What's this guy do again? All of this noise. Double strike and vigilance, and then one creature. 5 or greater.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty good.
You get some experience. You can be experienced, or you cannot be experienced. It's up to you.
I can do that. You know what? We're going to go ahead and just make double Kazool.
Okay. So,
it's a legendary. Legends. He's a legendary, isn't he? Yeah. So we'll do
another legendary creature.
Different legendary creature. And
just gold.
Do you get 2 gold tokens? That's 2 coins.
You don't. No. Get 1.
That's not a good rate for me.
So, King Makar, whenever he becomes untapped, he exiles target creature. And you put a colorless or a gold.
You or them?
They do. I'm not. I'm going to maze my king, though. And
you're not
going to
stop
I'm going to target.
Yeah.
The ogre?
No, I'm not going to target the ogre. I will just take out the double-striking nightmare.
Yeah.
He's so inspired.
He's so inspired.
Reach out and touch someone, King Makar.
We're going to reach out and touch the angel.
I understand.
That angel's been a little obnoxious.
It has been around for a while.
We're even, and that's fine.
Even Steven. I agree.
Except I'm going to kill Steven.
And I'm okay with that.
Even Steven, except not Steven.
Give me
get
my
your gold.
Yeah, you get all golds.
That's careful consideration.
Okay.
The main of phases?
You're definitely going to need to carefully consider whatever you're doing.
It's like losing.
You can do that without careful consideration.
You should just cast Maskerworm.
I don't have it.
That'd be pretty good, too.
I'm really looking for answers, but
really
I don't have it.
Maskerworm would be really nice.
I'd really like to draw Maskerworm.
That would be the greatest thing ever.
I'd really love to draw it.
In fact, if I could make you draw cards, I would...
Now, I only have to discard 2, but I'm choosing discard 3.
They're ready.
Ready.
No. I don't think you're ready for Duretti.
What are we doing?
Well, we really
I got
only
you a dice
have one option,
for your
so. We're going to discard 2 cards and draw up to that many.
It's a good choice.
I'll fetch.
Oh.
37.
Oh, he took.
Yeah. He took from them.
I'm probably going to take another 2.
He's getting aggressive with his life toll.
I am.
Going to 35?
You only start with 40, John.
I know.
He's off.
He already spent.
It's
my calculations, an 8th.
An 8th of his life total. Getting that mana right, though.
You can thought sees us, too.
Yeah, we're going to go Steve.
Yeah, I'm going to take 4.
No, he might take more than that. Parallel lives.
True.
They don't come into play tap and attack.
No, like, you just put them in.
Oh, the other two?
Yeah.
So you're still going to take 4.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to activate Crypt of Agadeem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Rearranging his graveyard.
Oh my gosh. Let me tell you, it's not going to matter. All right.
Didn't matter suddenly.
Yeah, suddenly.
He plays Corpse Dance. When this creature enters the battlefield, you have a trigger.
Yeah, I'm going to put 3 servers in the pay.
I might respond to your Marionette Master.
Okay.
Nah.
No?
Nah.
Go tutor in our way.
Okay. All right. 3 servos. Uh, I'm gonna sacrifice one to Phyrexian Altar, so everyone loses one from
Marionette's power.
Marionette Master's power. 35.
Not you either,
right?
33. 31. Yeah, we can dig. Hey, you can't block, right? Because you have tapped zombies. Make sure they are tapped. I thought
they're very tapped. Tapped. Okay, yeah. It's the last word.
I was like, I've played that card before, and I lost because all 13 zombies came into play tapped. And you guys attacked me in the face and killed me. Are you about to cast your general for the 19th time?
I believe it'll be the 4th.
4, 19. Sounds the same. Just to me that it costs... 16 mana.
14. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. Right?
Plus 6 and 6 is 12. Plus 11.
Yep. 4 times.
Ding, ding, ding.
We'll let Steven choose this time.
What? It's been me the whole game.
Yeah. Yeah, that's been my complaint every time. Oh, yeah.
You chose Steven. You got all lands. See what happens?
Have you played a land this turn?
No.
I
the bottle episode of Community, I believe.
Would like
the bottle? Where they all stayed in the study room because somebody stole Annie's pen.
Oh.
And then the
Oh no.
I'll stare. You want to get rid of all creatures
with converted mana cost 3 or greater. 4 or greater.
Three or less.
Right.
You're right.
And then I like my Cathar's Crusade.
Yeah, but you should get rid of it.
It has shroud.
I lose all my clues if I choose that. It's like bad value. I don't like losing value.
That's like discard 4 cards.
It is. It really is bad. I'm going to destroy all artifacts.
Ooh. The constructs.
I heard of my rush me and freeze.
I simply don't want to do it.
I don't want
to. I'll play a mountain.
Yep.
I'm going to plus Chandra.
Mana or card?
2 mana.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I thought you were going to take a card and kill Jeremy.
3, 4. Nice play. Null Brooch.
Can't read that card.
John knows what it does, though. It's a really sweet card.
Yeah, he can pay some mana, tap it, discard his hand, and counter target spell.
I tap it, tap 2, and discard my hand to counter spell.
Yeah. Counter target spell. That's a pretty good card.
If you have no hand, it's really good.
It is especially good.
It's real good.
Okay. It's especially good.
It's a good mud card, it seems like, since they often don't have a hand or it's junk.
I am going to pass the turn. What up?
we're just 3 guys looking for other guys who want to party in our party mansion.
I will play a mountain and not pass the turn, but instead play Mothis.
Hey.
Fiend Seeker.
What are you going to do? I don't have any creatures.
Pass the turn.
I Nobody has put an island into playoff Wayfarer's Bauble. So.
Play Pawn of Ulamog, and I will extort.
I'll go to 37. The other two go to 39. Jeremy goes to 44.
Extort, really good mechanic.
Go ahead.
Jeremy here.
Oof.
That's 10.
It is 10. 10.
10's a lot.
10 9.
And Commander here, and John with this one. And I had to bolster here. So I had to bolster the smallest one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right, what's coming at me?
Jermoka. 7, and he's taking 16.
16. Including 10. Because you didn't
everything
get to save
is, me. Because I didn't get to save Jeremy. Everything is ruined.
So that ruined your whole day.
Dragon Tempest.
Oh boy.
You're up.
Does anybody have an exile all cards Steven?
No, nope, sure don't.
I'm going to play Archmage Ascension.
I don't like that, though. That's.
Do you not?
How do you get quest counters?
You have to draw 2 or more cards. I'm going to end a turn, and I'm going to stack my triggers thusly. I'm going to draw my 2nd card off Fevered Vision.
Oh, thusly.
And then get a counter on Archmage Ascension. So I'm going to take 2 damage because I'm going to have exactly 4 cards. Then
you are. Yep. 28.
Goes 28.
And then we have a counter.
Yeah.
And search my library for a card.
Look, I can't do anything.
Don't you Adam West into
me. Wonder where he's
like
gonna...
this?
What's he going to search for?
What's
a zombie.
Search for? A zombie.
He's going to search for a big, nasty zombie.
Probably a zombie lord.
Zombie.
Maybe you should do that before you attack. I guess I have mana, so you're worried about me. But if anything, me playing Archmage Ascension tells you.
It doesn't tell us anything, Steve.
No.
It tells us nothing.
Didn't tell us anything, actually.
Tells us nothing.
Trying to ascend.
We're
trying to ascend
it
here.
Tells
we're
us
at the bottom.
I'm helping you. What?
No,
help,
you
help, help
me.
Help you hurt you.
You hurt me. Yeah.
Help me right. Help you hurt
I
you.
I know what I want.
It was painful.
Where'd it go?
I think it's at the front.
It's called Goose Noosna? Noosna? Noosgraf Mob. I'm going to play that, too.
That kills everything, and there's four triggers.
Nope. Are we resolving the Kriya Pain Cycle?
Yes.
Right. So one, two, three. Die. We have three Blood Artist triggers. I'm going to draw a card.
Where's those Blood Artist triggers going?
Well, there was already...
That one's already resolved.
That one resolved.
That's why I'm at four.
Okay, so they're all going at you. That's one.
Son of a gun. I'm at one.
You go to 55. All right. Attrition.
Attrition. So that's just dead. Okay.
Card in your hand, John?
Draw my card. I did draw my card.
I'm going to make everybody lose one. With the Jordan Swamp.
I'll go to 12. Steven's at 7. How many cards are in your deck?
Not enough. Seven. Yeah.
Seven cards. I've been waiting my whole life for this.
I was trying to save you from being milled, all right? That's literally all I was doing.
Is that what you were doing?
I was really
saving
trying
who
to.
From being milled? Yourself?
Justin and myself, mostly.
How was Justin going to get milled?
I get milled some.
I'm going to get milled for like 15, right? 14, something like that.
I'll draw. Oh, this is the back of my hand.
Nah, during your turn. Oh no, he killed me on that stuff.
Yeah.
I didn't actually save it.
I just want to make sure this jar gets popped.
No reason to pop a jar.
It kills Jeremy.
Yeah, but he can do that whenever he wants.
I'm gonna cast Wheel.
Oh, that's do it. Probably better.
Fortune.
I'm gonna discard my hand.
I'm also
draw
gonna
seven?
Discard my hand.
All right. Yep.
How many you got there?
Where's the rest
seven.
Of the insects?
Coming in.
Yeah. Done?
I'm done.
In your turn, I'm going to fix it up for two.
Yeah, yeah.
Nothing major here.
35, though.
Technically,
didn't
I have a blue permanent,
even,
right?
Nope. That's colorless.
That's colorless.
Didn't even start with C. That's why it's... That's why
it's, that's why it's not. It's I told him that earlier.
It's bad if you're getting Merciless Executioner'd every turn.
This is a good one, though. Let's play Golgari Charm.
What does that one do?
That
I'm going to choose the modes. All creatures get -1/-1 until end of turn.
Makes me a sad face.
I'm going to go to 28 for casting
great.
It.
Yeah.
Great, John.
Jeremy goes to 40, right?
Yeah.
Great, John. Just what I wanted.
What else? Do you have anything else?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, I do. I'm going to play Merciless Executioner.
Yeah, yes.
And when my Merciless Executioner dies, I'll get an experience counter. This is fun.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't like any of this.
I don't like any of this.
Yeah, me either. He doesn't even let me play Magic.
I'm going to play a Sabertooth.
A Teamer Sabertooth?
Teamer Sabertooth. That's real good.
All right. Time to... Get going. Where are we at, life total?
Jeremy's
wise?
Still.
God,
he's
Jeremy,
at 40.
You dumb. It's your fault.
Shrug.
Nine Marin.
Well, 34. I told you were falling into the trap.
This is not good for business. I'm going to pick up Magus of the Coffers and give this indestructible.
Okay.
And I'll pick up. List of a traitor and give it indestructible.
Okay.
And then we can resolve Maskstorm.
Okay.
I'm going to move this over here. I'll lose 4.
Yep. So you go to 19. And then I'm going to cast Mystic Confluence using my guess this turn.
We're all taking 2.
Everyone's going to take 2. 14. 59 for you, Steven?
Yeah.
Not counting Jeremy's.
About 13 for Jeremy. I got it.
I'm going to...
That's 17.
Modes on the copy.
One, two, three, bounce their hand. And then
that's
I'm...
the first one.
And then I'm going to draw three cards.
He cost 500 less the other turn.
Yeah, he did. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8.
The Rieto Massacre was a testament to the commies' unstoppable power.
What do...
The human defenders might as well have been moths battling a forest fire.
Is this before I block your Yose or after?
It's before. Get out of here. You're not blocking anything.
I really want to block your Yose.
Your flesh has been rended.
I'll float a white.
Okay.
I'll play Seth's Tiger.
What's it do?
It doesn't do anything.
I'm going to choose blue when it comes into play. I have protection from blue till end of turn.
Okay. Well, there's still a lot coming at you.
Not this one. This
one's 11.
Blue.
There's 11 coming at you.
But I was going to survive.
To do what? For me to cast some more spirits? For me to loop so you have no hand?
For now.
You have Valen.
I'm just going to draw two of them. I'm going to draw two of them, ultimately. Okay. I just draw...
Lose 8.
I'll draw these two.
Alright, lose.
No, four. I don't lose anything.
I saw it all resolved with Sylvan Library. That's all I saw. You looked at three cards, you took two, you took four life. That's what I saw.
That's what I saw too.
Alright, I'm going to play Guy's Crib.
Oh, come on.
And I'm also going to make sure the creatures cannot deal combat damage three times this turn.
Excellent. You sure showed me.
I know I did.
It's a good thing that he Wrathguarded, or you guess my loss again.
It's true. Well, I wouldn't have if he didn't destroy my Snaring Bridge. There's my spirits.
That's true. That Snaring Bridge did a lot of work against me.
See, my board was cleared anyway. Whatever. We could have done it like a turn ago.
Yeah. Well, you didn't take any damage this time. Can we draw a card first? Can we draw a card first? I think
we all
need to
draw. That's a good one.
It's going to make fun.
Yes. Let's draw some.
Everyone
cards.
Draw?
I'm cycling the Fetipools.
You don't have priority to do that, Steven.
Just let him do
all
it.
Right, fine. Do it. No, it's gone.
Now we're just wasting.
I'm gonna activate this Jace Telepath. I'm bound to pass priority to you.
All right, I'm good.
Okay. Let's add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Yep.
I'm gonna spend 4 of it to summary dismissal and exile all spells and counter all abilities.
Nope.
Okay.
And I got multi.
I draw my
and
card.
Then we resolve, Jace.
Yep.
Draw a card.
I got a trigger.
The exile is part of the cost. Nope. It is not. The cost is just colors, blue, black, right?
Oh, yeah. You countered it. All right, someone, you choose.
I'll put this zombie into play. I'll play that zombie.
How much? 8?
It's just 8.
Just
awesome. With 3 awesome. CDC. 25. And then
what?
Put yourself at 27?
25.
Hypothetically. John plays a Rafik.
Hypothetically.
And then hypothetically, I clone the Rafik.
Hypothetically.
And then John attacks Jeremy, and then I attack Jeremy.
No.
Nope. It's got to be the same physical...
I mean, they are the same.
No.
It's a literal clone.
Oh. It's a literal clone.
They're the same DNA.
It's multiple Michael Keaton.
Yeah.
Multiple Jan Michael Vincent's.
Yes.
It's the last one, though. The last one.
I'm going to cast Sylvan Scrying for a...
You're not... That's not...
That's not Explore.
That's not how you get... That's not how you get the sigils out. All of them.
Savannah. Well, like, I want the sigils out with a Mariki Ribi or whatever on it.
Going to swing?
Yeah, I am going to swing.
Was that insulted?
Oh, he could have swung at me and he didn't.
And Jeremy, I'm at your mercy for most of the game here.
I remember what happened last time that happened.
You were at my mercy?
That you were at my mercy? Then
mercy.
I died.
Oh, well, I'm still at your mercy.
I was like, I got all these merfolk. I could just, like, swing and kill you whenever.
I'm at your mercy again. No, well, this game...
You're at everyone's mercy.
I would say, this game, you will not die in the same
Remember how
manner.
You were freaking out about that Twilight card the other day? Twilight
oh
Prophet?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That now anyone can cough on you and you die.
So you got...
That's true.
You got the best, worst thing you could get out of Twilight Prophet.
Yeah, I know.
Land.
Well, that's good. You're normally with Dark Confidant, you want to draw
I'm
going to
play an Evil Twin.
Twin.
I don't like that.
Who shall it be?
Shall be many sigils.
One purpose.
Two purposes now.
Not really. You can't target
John.
It.
John.
You know I can't block.
I'll hit you for 5. 21. Trigger. I'm going to play Holagon's Command. I'm going to deal 2 to this and destroy an artifact. I'm going to maintain priority and dual caster mage. I'm going to do 2 to this and return Direfleet Daredevil to my hand.
End of your turn. Let's play Wolfbriar Elemental with Kicker of...
That's some tokens.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Kicker of 8.
I'm going to...
Yeah, I got a 1-1. It's 2-2 now. Is that good?
Yes.
Jeremy?
Yeah, it's the Jeremy Mayak show right now.
I mean...
Well, he's in combat now, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's not the show
second
anymore.
Main face.
It's not the show. He doesn't have any more colors.
I don't have any more colors.
That's true.
This doesn't add.
Yeah,
does not.
Add 1 mana of any color.
Good thing I killed that reliquary tower.
I know, right?
Yeah, good thing I killed the Fate Spinner.
Steven, I want to activate my Elspeth.
Targeting.
I want to target your creature.
Well, target it.
I feel like...
I'm killing the Captivating Vampire. I ain't going to lie about it. I can't let him start taking my dragons.
He's going to get a big old dragon.
Sorry, Jeremy. I literally can't let that happen.
What you got? One spell.
Okay,
I'm dead.
No, you're not.
These are XL forever, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Snapcaster's not very good.
No, it's not. Thank you for exiling it.
Are you playing your Seize the Deck?
Mm-mm. I'm playing this Insurrection.
Okay, so...
He's dead already.
Jeremy's dead.
Yeah. I got the caterpillar.
I'm dead.
I would have gotten there at all 4 pieces.
Steven, I would like to give you my Worm and my Anafenza.
I would not like to give you anything. However,
I will give
you everything.
yeah, you will.
Now, I will remind you.
What's up?
Creatures
did you play a land?
Can't attack.
Because you get this too. How does this work?